Again, we want to solve this equation for the variable A. So we're trying to isolate A. There's a wide variety of algebra skills in the course at this point. So I'm going to do this in the most general way. We're not going to make use of any shortcuts, no black magic. We're simply going to use the laws of algebra, which say that we can add the same thing to both sides. We can multiply both sides of an equation by the same thing. We can, of course, reverse sides, and several others, just a few others, actually. There are only about half a dozen tricks that you have to know to solve an equation of this nature. So let's see what we can do. We begin with this equation, and we subtract V naught delta t from both sides, because V naught delta t is not attached to that A in any way. And if we subtract it from both sides by writing the delta S side is delta S minus V naught delta t, writing the right-hand side minus V naught delta t, you see that the right-hand side becomes 1 half A delta t squared. You might ask, why didn't we get rid of the 1 half and the delta t? That's because we get rid of terms that are added to terms involving A before we attempt to get rid of anything that's attached to it by multiplication. You can try it the other way. It can be done, but it's much more difficult to start with a division, for example, than it is to start with a subtraction. Okay, now, we have this. What do we do? Well, we've got A, and A has a coefficient of 1 half delta t squared. That is, 1 half delta t squared is multiplied by A. What can we do? We can multiply by the reciprocal of 1 half delta t squared, which is 2 over delta t squared. So we multiply both sides of the equation by 2 over delta t squared. The 2 will be divided by the 2 to give us 1. The delta t squared will divide into the delta t squared, which will give us 1. And we'll just have A times 1 times 1, which is A. So that the right-hand side becomes A. And of course, that's what we're trying to get. We're trying to solve for A. The left-hand side, if we take 2 times our delta S minus V naught delta t, and then over our delta t squared, well, we get our equation for A. We can distribute the 2 through this addition, delta S added to negative V naught delta t. You might think of that as a subtraction, but I usually just talk about addition of a negative. And here we can, we distribute the 2 throughout, and then we distribute division by delta t squared, or multiplication by the reciprocal of delta t squared over the numerator, and we get this expression. So A is 2 delta S over delta t squared minus 2 V naught over delta t.